Hey, so Helium 10, Review Velocity. In this video, I'm going to explain to you how you can leverage the Review Velocity tab inside the Helium 10 Chrome extension to grow your Amazon business. So we're going to talk about what the Review Velocity tab even means, what are the green numbers here, what are the red numbers. I'm going to show it and explain to you step by step. Then I'm going to explain to you how you can find better products to sell on Amazon by understanding Review Velocity. Then I'm going to explain to you how you can avoid potentially bad products by understanding Review Velocity. And then finally, I'm going to explain to you how you can get more reviews to your products on Amazon that you're currently selling or the products that you're going to be selling by understanding Review Velocity. Now, Review Velocity tab is part of the Helium 10 Chrome extension, which you can get for free by clicking on the link down in the description of this video. The link will take you to this landing page where you are going to be able to get the Helium 10 Chrome extension for completely free. Another link that I'm going to have for you is going to lead you to this landing page where you're going to be able to get a free Helium 10 account with a free trial, but also you're going to be able to get discount coupon codes for Helium 10. VOVA50 saves you 50% off your first month on Helium 10. VOVA10 saves you 10% off recurring every month on Helium 10. These are good for the monthly and the yearly plans, and they work on the Platinum, Diamond, and the Carte plans. And my name is Vova Evan. I'm a seller on Amazon, been selling there actively since late 2016, and I'm still actively selling in the trenches. And up here I have a playlist for you and down in the description that has over 70 plus Helium 10 tutorials that show you how to use Helium 10 in a better way. So let's start the tutorial. Now, what is Review Velocity? Change in the review count over the last 30 days. What does that mean? For example, this product, Michelangelo Kitchen Knife, received 256 reviews in the last 30 days from 11,000 sales. We can see the sales tab here as well. On the other hand, we see the DDFIOHEF, which is a great brand name, I'd say, product that has lost 2,741 reviews, right? So he lost a lot of reviews. You might be like, what happened there? Well, probably it was review manipulation or some other thing that happened, but the red one means that the product lost reviews. The green one means that he received. So that's just briefly to explain what the review velocity is. Now, what we should also look at is the sales to reviews. So for example, if we look here, the sales of this product Michelangelo is 11,000, right? And the reviews he received from these products, from these sales, is 256. So also what you can do, and what I like doing, is I like having the sales kind of a tab here close to the review velocity. So then I can look at them. I can look, this one has 11,000 sales, this one has 256 reviews, like their sales to reviews ratio. Now, let's get to point number one, how you can find good products to sell on Amazon by understanding review velocity. Now, how do you do that? Well, you should be looking at the review velocity, obviously, once you're scanning like a page of keyword on Amazon. Let's say your product is going to be here and you find the main keyword for this product. Let's say here it is a kitchen knife. You click on the Helium 10 Chrome extension. It's going to appear in the right upper corner of your Chrome browser. You click on X-ray. It's going to scan all the products on the given page. And then what you can do, as I mentioned, move to the sales nearby the review velocity. Now, what's a good thing to see in a niche? Good thing to see in a niche is review velocity that is low. Right? Generally, it's good to see a low review count, right? But also, if you see a lower review velocity count, that means that the people that are selling in that niche are not that good at getting reviews. And you might be like, wait a minute, dude, like, what is the low review ratio? Like, is it 10%? Is it 3%? Well, it depends on the niche. But for example, look at this here. This one has sold 11,000 units approximately, right? And received 256 reviews. That's about 2.5% of review from sales to reviews. Now this one, on the other hand, the Y2 OMSI, sold 1,065 units and received 102 reviews. So 10% review ratio, that's pretty high, to be honest. That's a pretty high review ratio. And if you have a niche where everybody are getting reviews fast, that's actually not that good. So to find a better niche, right, that's the first thing, good product, is actually finding niches where the review velocity is low. So for example, the competitor that is the main competitor, the second competitor, they do sales, they do pretty good sales, right? But the reviews they're getting are low in terms of like low amount of reviews. So when you enter the niche and you have some ideas on how to get reviews, then you can surpass them in the amount of reviews. And even if not surpass them, at least get close to them. And how you can do that if you're like, I don't even know how to get reviews. Or first up here is going to be a playlist of how to get reviews on Amazon, and also down in the description. Okay, there are many techniques on how to do that, so this playlist is going to help you. But generally, if you see that they're not getting reviews as well, that's a great sign for you. So even if you don't really know how to get reviews, right, you're still going to be able to get some reviews. Usually they just come organically once you get the sales, but then you're going to be able at least to stay in the game with them. Because if they surpass you fast on the reviews, right, with time, they're going to get a lot far from you. And they're going to get more clicks on their products, more conversions, because they have better ways of getting reviews. And maybe you're not going to lose sales necessarily, because reviews is not everything, but they do really matter in Amazon and generally in online, in e-commerce. So I do recommend you look into niches where the review velocity generally amongst most of the competitor is lower. The second option is the opposite. The bad option is everybody is like this, 10%, 10%, 10%. It's going to be hard for you, right, to stay in the game because they already know how to get reviews fast. And then if you see that it's not all the niche, like some products are not getting as many reviews because some products or some niches might generally be niches where there are more reviews coming in, maybe more emotional products. It really depends on the niche. For example, if you buy like a sponge for the kitchen, not necessarily that the review ratio is going to be high unless you know how to get reviews. That's why I recommend you watching the reviews playlist, link in the description. But again, if it's not good and many are getting a lot of reviews, 10% review velocity, 15%, and the new sellers are not getting them as well, and some competitors just running away, right? They're getting like in the same amount of sales as everyone else, they get the same amount of reviews. I'm sorry, they get a higher amount of reviews. That's actually not good for you. So look at that parameter when you're overlooking a niche. If you see like some competitors that are getting ahead in the reviews, look 2 years from now. Maybe you're gonna be, you know, with 200 reviews, they're going to be with a few thousands. It's going to impact your conversion rate and click-through rate on your listing. Again, it's not everything, right? Still, you got to differentiate the product, and reviews is not everything on the Amazon game, but it really means a lot. If you can click the like button before we continue, it's going to help. Always forget to ask for that, or dislike if you're not enjoying. That's going to help. Thank you very much. And the third thing is how you can get more reviews with the review velocity tab. So let me explain to you. So how do you get more reviews? Well, what you're going to do is you're going to find the people in different niches, not necessarily the niche that you're in or some niches you're looking at, or probably you're going to be looking at those niches, but look at the people with exceptionally high review velocity for that specific niche. So for example, if all the niches like 5%, 3%, suddenly there's someone on 15%, right? The review velocity, so that's sales to reviews. What you're going to do is you're going to buy their product, right? Physically, you're going to buy their product on Amazon and get it to your home. And what you're going to do after that is the next thing. You're going to be very, so to say, strategic about what's happening. So you're going to see if there are any emails coming from that seller, any messages on Amazon, off Amazon, see what he does. Like, is there any way that he gets those reviews? For example, what might happen is you might receive a really nice email, like very emotional email, very personal email, for example, after you bought it, right? That might eventually lead to a review, right? Because maybe you've gotten really kind of personal with the brand, and after a while they ask you for a review, which might be a higher chance of getting a review. Next thing you would like to do is you're gonna, once you receive the product, you're gonna be very attentive to the details of the product. That means maybe the product that has gotten so many reviews and is getting that many reviews is actually fixing something in the niche that demanded a lot of attention, something that really hurts to the people and other people are not doing, and they found that problem and they're fixing that. People are talking about that in the reviews and they're actually leaving the reviews. Maybe there's a product that, maybe a knife here that is that strong that it can cut like anything, right? That would be a pretty cool knife, right? You gotta be really careful with that knife, but that would be a great knife. That would be really easy. It really eases the process. So it's exceptional, right? Then people will leave more reviews. Also, what might happen is maybe the packaging is really cool. Maybe you open the packaging and maybe there's a little sound playing. Hey, welcome to the kitchen. Let's like, chances are low that this might happen. But if you do that to your product, that's really like, this surprises the person. The person's like, what the hell? That's really nice. Like, and then when you ask for a review, then that's pretty cool. And you can do that automatically with, for example, Helium 10. They have a review request, right? Inside Helium 10 and the follow-up tool, they have an option to request reviews, right? From sellers or from buyers. And once someone buys, like, let's say 7 days after the purchase, like maybe after 3 days they receive the package and that cool music plays, they're all excited. After 7 days, there's an automatic plugin that asks them for a review. The chances of review are higher. Or maybe what's gonna happen is inside the box, there's gonna be a little card, right? That says like, scan here and receive something, right? They scan there, the brand takes their email and then gets them into the funnel of sending them different, maybe emails, some recipes for the kitchen, maybe they send them a gift, knows, maybe something like that. And after a while they ask for review after giving them a lot of value, then the chance of review is higher. Or maybe there's a little gift inside the box that was not mentioned. Maybe that's a knife and you get a knife sharpener, right? Just out of the box, like, hey, wow, that's cool. You didn't expect that. And here's like a little gift that's glued there to the box or something. Like, hey, maybe you were not expecting that. It's reading on the box. Here's something cool for you. Enjoy it. Right, that's pretty cool, right? People are gonna be like, wow, I didn't expect that. That really helps this product to use it better. I can sharpen the knife. That's pretty awesome, right? So this is another way you can use the review velocity to get even more reviews on Amazon. To get the Chrome extension, click on the link down in the description of this video. Get the Chrome extension for free along with all the discount codes. And up here, I'm going to leave you the playlist of other Helium 10 tutorials, where I have 70 plus tutorials for you of Helium 10. Hopefully this one was helpful. Click here to watch more of the Helium 10 tutorials so you can leverage them better and Helium 10 better itself for your Amazon business, hopefully grow it. And I wish you a great life. Bye-bye.